For those of us who believe, we must be bold in our faith right now. When you gather in public spaces, pray thankfully over your food. Even when the server gives you the stink eye or tells the manager that your peaceful grace is triggering them. Had it happen to me, I've been asked to leave a restaurant for openly bowing my head in prayer hands. In America, it's all good. They don't deserve my money anyway.
Harris Faulkner very bravely disclosed a story with the public that was definitely real, definitely happened, and definitely was not made up. And I thank her for that, because those were some strong words, a very strong anecdote about what she definitely experienced as she was enjoying her meal at a restaurant.
Quote an Adam McKay movie, I think there's a mathematically 0% chance that that happened.
Come on, guys.
Okay. So like really in America, you're gonna get kicked out of a restaurant for praying and you're a Fox News host and you're not gonna go make a big deal out of that the next day on air. You're just gonna let it slide and many years later or many months later, just in passing say, oh, by the way, I was kicked out of a restaurant right. for praying.
As you're subbing for Tucker Carlson's old primetime spot on Fox News.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
The degree to which that story did not happen is indescribable. Okay, and by the way, if they're looking at you weird, that's happened to me too. And it's not because I was in thought for prayer, you know, before.
Yeah, people look at you weird all the time.
Well, first of all, that's definitely true, period. Okay, look at me. But seriously, sometimes I'll get super high and I'll go to and have a nice dinner, okay?
That's his religious experience.
Yeah, that's my religious experience. And when I want to really soak in the food, I do this like, okay.
Oh my God, Cenk, have you been kicked out of a restaurant for that?
No, but people look at you weird. And they should, because you're being a weirdo. Okay, so it's a little unusual. It's not that big a deal, right? But when you do something a little unusual, people kind of look at you, right?
Right.
But she probably saw that. She probably got like one or two stink eyes or something, because they didn't know what she was doing. And she thought, oh my God. America hates Christians, we're so persecuted. And look, then like left a restaurant or whatever, or maybe she made it up entirely, I don't know. But okay. She did not get kicked out, name the restaurant.
And by the way, if that happened, if there's some proof that that actually happened, I'd be against it. You shouldn't kick
of
people
course,
out. Like I don't care, course. Like people should be allowed to pray. And by the way, that should be applied to people of all religions, all religions.
And all different kinds of weed. Okay, it could be sativa, it could be indica.
Look at you.
Either way.
Maybe a hybrid?
Could be a hybrid. Look, you want climate change. You got climate change coming on. You want to go to a hybrid.
Can't believe I'm sitting next to a man who worships the devil's lettuce.
Oh, and I once got kicked out of a restaurant for that. But I never told you guys.
Okay, hold on. Maybe we're being unfair to her. Let's hear more of her story and what she had to say.
It's as though people on the left have more free time than anybody else. They want to acronym and pronoun us to death. We'll know this. The Lord has determined I am a woman and my pronouns are USA.
Come on. That was, no, you got to give her the slot just based on that. That was hilarious. My pronouns are USA. You guys are goofballs, man.
No, it's just the delivery, like you gotta work, like take some acting classes, you'll improve, you gotta sell it a little better. You just do, yeah.
So look, she's not gonna get the job. Okay, let's keep it real. Wanna know who's gonna get the job?
Not really.
Okay, I'll tell you.
Okay.
I'll tell you anyway, even though you don't wanna. Okay, someone who's been kicked out of two restaurants for praying, no. No, it's gonna be a white male. It's gonna be like Jesse Waters or Greg Gutfeld or someone that looks just like them, okay? And then they're gonna do these segments where they make fun of everyone that isn't an old white man, and the audience is gonna love it, okay? Jesse Waters is gonna make fun of Chinese people in Chinatown, he's gonna make fun, attack furries, he's gonna do all these disgusting, horrible things, and the crowd's gonna go nuts. Harris Faulkner, you know, this is a nice, you know, college effort, but not gonna work. Okay.
So let's talk a little bit about religious persecution in America, discriminatory behavior toward religious people, because that does happen in the United States. So it's not far-fetched. I just there's something about her delivery, there's something about her decision to talk about this at the time she decided to talk about it that makes me question the veracity of what she's saying, right? But with that said, there is religious discrimination that's worth talking about. In fact, back in 2017, Pew Research did a study on this, and here's what they found. 48% of the respondents say they were subjected to at least one discriminatory incident based on religion over the past year, compared with 40% a decade ago. A large majority, 75%, said there's a lot of discrimination against Muslims in the United States.
Of course.
Yeah, but that's okay, right? I mean, Fox News had no problem with that.
Yeah.
Now, and look, I'm an atheist, so all of the voodoo I don't believe in, okay? And I have no malice against Christians, no malice against Muslims. That is the religious doctrine they want to believe in. Same with Jewish people, the religious doctrine they want to believe in. I believe in religious freedom. I do. I also believe in freedom from religion, and I also believe in treating people well and not judging them or discriminating against them based on what their doctrine is. Now, if they force their doctrine into my life, into dictating my life, then I have a problem with that. But let me give you more from this 2017 Pew Research study. About a third of Muslims said they have been treated with suspicion at least once over the past year, the highest in Pew survey since 2007. Nearly one in five said they have been called offensive names, and a similar share have seen anti-Muslim graffiti in their communities. 6% said they were physically threatened or attacked, identical to the share saying this back in 2011. So I remember doing stories, Cenk, back in 2015, I believe, where Muslim women wearing burkinis at the beach were being harassed by, you know, anti-Muslim bigots and all of that. And it seems to have died down a little bit. Now the ire is directed toward the LGBTQ community.
They always gotta find some other.
But there's always some group that conservatives feel the need to latch onto an attack.
Yeah, so I've told this story a couple times before, but I was on a plane and I was sitting next to a conservative guy from, I think he was from Indiana, if I remember right. And we had a great time. We're talking back and forth. We're having a hoot. Maybe we talk sports, we talk general life. And then he found out that I'm an atheist. And he's like, oh, damn, okay. And that's a shame. You seem like a good guy. And I was like, don't worry. I used to be Muslim. He's like, oh, yeah, okay. Then it's an improvement.
A better, better.
And then we had a good laugh over it, right? So like, it's okay. I'm not a touchy guy, right?
Yeah.
In fact, my pronouns are LOL.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.